as you guys know, I'm kind of dieting or just eating healthier. So this is my breakfast. And it's just as delicious as IHOP, isn't it? I swear I'm doing okay. I swear. I hate my life. No, but in all seriousness, I actually do love fruit and I love these melons together. This is from King Soopers. So it comes with all three in the thing for $5.11, which is not bad. So I do enjoy these for breakfast. I enjoy them for a snack, dessert, anything. I love me some fruit. Up for another doctor's appointment. What a shock, but it's like a family trip. My whole family is coming. And I got an idea from my sister, my soul sister, Lori, who is doing Vlogoween and Vlogtober, and she's doing a great job. I'm so excited and happy for her. She's showing like all her Halloween decorations so far and everything. But the way my house is set up, it's like we don't have that much room for like a ton of Halloween decorations. We still have to buy more. And we're really late. It's pissing me off. But most of my room all year long has Halloween stuff in it. So, you know. But I forgot back near my birthday, my best friend Josh sent me a package, a birthday package. And I forgot to show you. First, he got this really awesome 3D kind of really cute card for me. Let me see. It just says, "Hope you enjoyed your day. You're a stupid bitch. Love, Josh." So I love this so much. This is going in my binder. He sent me a whole bunch of collector's items, including these two, my favorite besides Frankenfurter. These are like collectible little tiny little figures of Magenta and Columbia, who I love. And I think I'm going to display these downstairs as Halloween decorations. I think they would suit for Halloween decorations. And I will show you what we have going on downstairs so far. This is what my tree looks like. Oh, and when the wind and the breeze blows through it, oh, you can hear the crunching. Oh my god, it's my favorite sound in the world. Okay, so that's where they're gonna be going for now. Just for now. We're in my living room. So let's try to not show Mama Blaze and Papa Blaze on camera. Well, Papa Blaze, who cares? Say hi, Papa. Yeah, he's had a long night of inventory. So this is the, what would you call this? A divider that separates our living room to our dining room-ish kitchen. So this is what we got lined up on here. We got some Frankensteins and some Punchkins. And some owls. I heard that. And this is the foyer. And this is the thing we have in the foyer. So this is what it looks like at the moment. We need to get a bowl that's gonna sit here. That's gonna have the candy in it. I love handing out candy, actually. It makes me happy. So we got that going on. This reminds me of Sam from Trick or Treat, and he's my son, and I love him. And look, Brittany, I have your stuff up. They're amazing. Oh, and we got some fall flowers. And just on our front door, can't open. We have a "Enter if you dare" sign. So that's it as far as decorations go so far. Look at how pretty. How pretty. Remember that crazy hailstorm that I posted that video of? Yeah, everybody has still been getting their roofs fixed. Still going on after over a month and a half. And the car is damaged, and we've seen other people's cars damaged.
And like, there's commercials like on TV and on the radio for that storm in general, that they'll fix everything that happened. So that was crazy. I love these colors.
Okay, no more joking. This is getting absolutely ridiculous.
So I just finished recording a Halloween tag video for Vlogtober, Vlogoween. So now I am just going to be editing and uploading. Yay, I hope you guys like it.
The first frost of the season. How exciting.
Can you see my breath? I can see my breath. TCM is having a silent horror movie marathon, and I'm so happy. I love, love, love these movies. They are so great. Ugh, classic. It's so comforting. I love falling asleep to these movies. Oh, fini.
The eerie world of witchcraft comes alive for children on Halloween, but all the year around. deserted house becomes an object of dread. If it has a history of disaster or sudden death, it automatically becomes a haunted house and a challenge to juvenile courage. Next to fear, superstition breeds best on curiosity. The little girl who asks, love me not, of a daisy, will often grow up to ask the same questions of a Ouija board. We all want, at times, to take an unauthorized peek into the future, and so the black arts still flourish. Your destiny can be read in the shadows that cloud a crystal ball, in the mystic combination of a spread of cards, in the lines and creases on the palm of your hand, in the bumps and knobs on your head, and in the soggy sediment in your teacup. Much more ominous is the belief in cures by dark sorcery. Each year, hundreds of Americans die because they go to a wizard instead of a doctor. This man's sudden lameness is diagnosed as a hex put on by an enemy. Prescription? Burn the candle with your enemy's name on it and stick a pin into the conjure doll. Strange medicine in this atomic age, but it pays well. $5. But to the average American, the harmless superstition such as spilled salt tossed over the left shoulder, that's just an old custom. Nor is there any extra luck in finding a pin. It's only housewifely thriftiness to pick it up. And if you walk under a ladder, something might fall on you. As for meeting up with a black cat, well, we're not really superstitious, just cautious. Many hotel guests would sooner sleep in the lobby than spend a night in a room numbered 13. And yet, on the medieval assumption that when you change the name, you change the magic, the same room labeled 12A is okay. Hotel rooms are often designed so it's impossible to get out on the left or unlucky side of the bed. Despite our modern sophistication, many Americans still dress in the morning according to an